Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Angular Breadcrumb component. In general, the Angular Breadcrumb identifies the user's current location within the hierarchical structure of a website. In this video, I am going to show you how to add an Angular Breadcrumb component to an Angular app, and then I will explain how to generate the breadcrumb item text and customize it, enable navigation to the last item, set overflow modes, and set relative and absolute URLs in the breadcrumb component. In this video, I will show you the steps to create an Angular project using the Angular CLI tool. I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output result on Google Chrome, but any of the supported browsers will work. First, I need to install the Angular CLI on my machine using this command: npm install -g at angular/cli. Since I have already installed Angular CLI in my machine, I am skipping this step. Now, let's proceed to create a new Angular project by typing the command ng new project name. I am going to create a project without the routing option, so let me set no here. And choose the CSS option to add a CSS style sheet. The project creation has started, and this will create an Angular project along with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, I navigate to the newly created project folder. To start using the Syncfusion Angular Breadcrumb, I need to install the Syncfusion Angular Navigations package by using this command: npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularnavigations --save. This will install the package along with its dependencies. Alright, the Syncfusion Angular Navigations package is installed, and now my application is ready. The first thing I need to do here is to add the breadcrumb component. Before that, I need to register the Syncfusion Angular trial license key, so open this main.ts file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Then, register the Angular trial license key using the register license method. From the 2022 Volume 1 release onwards, it is required to register the Syncfusion Angular license key. To see where to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Now, let's add the breadcrumb component. First, open the app module file and import the breadcrumb module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Navigations package. And register the same module within the imports array of the ng module section. Open this app component HTML file. Remove the default content and define the Angular breadcrumb component using the EJS breadcrumb tag. Next, let me add CSS reference for the breadcrumb. Open this style.css file and import the material theme. Okay, now I am going to run this example using the command ng serve. This example is compiled successfully. You can see the breadcrumb component rendered with the home icon. Next, I will show you how to add items to the component. To do that, let me define a breadcrumb items tag, which accepts n number of breadcrumb item definitions. I plan to add 5 items, so I add 5 breadcrumb item tags with appropriate text. Then, define the URL property with the appropriate path for these items. Here, I have set relative URLs for the breadcrumb items. Look here, the defined items of the breadcrumb component are shown. You can see the component contains the path, but not the location. Next, let's see how absolute URLs work in the component. I am planning to set absolute URLs for the items, so set absolute URL links to the URL property. Breadcrumb items with absolute URLs contain the path and location of the resource. See now, clicking the items navigates to the location path. Also, the URL link opens in the same page. If I want to open the link in a new page, then use the before item render event. To do that, let me define the before item render event with an appropriate event handler. Then, I define the method openURL in new page, which receives argument of type breadcrumb before item render events args. Within this method, check whether args.element has children, then set the target property to blank. Now, on clicking the breadcrumb item, the defined URL opens in a new page. By default, the last item navigation is turned off. If I want to enable it, then set enable active item navigation as true. Click the last item, it navigates to the location path. Notice here, all the items are shown in the breadcrumb component. Suppose I want to limit the items, then I would use the max items property. Now, I am going to show 3 items in the component and hide the others, so let me set the max limit to 3. You can see in the component 3 items are shown and the other items are collapsed. Also, the hidden items are shown when the ellipsis icon is clicked. Next, I will show how to customize the separators with arrow icons. First, I create a template using the ng template tag and assign it to a template reference variable, separator template. I want to display arrow icons in component, so add span element with class attribute. Then, set the class names as ebicons and eArrowNames. Within this style CSS file, I will define a font face with a specific SRC path and name its font family to start accessing the required font icons for this breadcrumb component at the application level. Then, I will assign the appropriate content values to access the needed font icons. Also, I have set a few CSS styles for this breadcrumb component's item separators. Now, you can see the arrow icon is inserted between the breadcrumb component items. Next, I will show you how to set the overflow mode. The Syncfusion Angular breadcrumb component supports 6 types of overflow mode: collapsed, menu, wrap, scroll, hidden, and none. Here, I plan to wrap the breadcrumb component items to multiple lines, so define the overflow mode and set its value as wrap. Looking now, the breadcrumb component items are wrapped to multiple lines when the breadcrumb's width exceeds the container space. Similarly, you can set the other overflow modes. By default, navigation will be enabled when URL property is set for breadcrumb items. If I want to prevent navigation, simply set enable navigation property to false. See here, the item navigation is in disabled state. Let's recap what we have done in this video. We saw how to create an Angular app and add the Syncfusion Angular breadcrumb component to it. We saw how to generate the breadcrumb item text, enable navigation to the last item, set overflow modes, and set relative and absolute URLs in the breadcrumb component. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire Angular suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.